Hi everyone, in this video I want to show you how to set up the WireGuard VPN on your Asus router. I'm gonna also show you how to configure a client so to access this WireGuard VPN from the internet and to be able to browse the internet from anywhere in the world as if you were on your own home network. Setting up WireGuard is very easy and consists of four main steps. The first step is creating a DDNS entry. The second step is to configure the WireGuard VPN on your router. The third step is to share the configuration file with the clients of this WireGuard VPN. And the fourth and last step is configuring the client. In my example, I'll be using the Asus router RT-AX3000, but the instructions I'm gonna show you apply also to all Asus routers that support the WireGuard VPN protocol. For routers other than Asus routers, if they support the WireGuard VPN protocol, you can simply match the instructions I'm gonna show you on my Asus router to the instructions that you're gonna find on your router. So let's go to our Asus admin page to start with creating a DDNS entry. So this is the admin page of my Asus router. To create a dynamic DNS entry, you need to go to one. So it is on the left here, click on it, and then click on DDNS tab on the top. So here to create a DDNS entry, you have enabled the DDNS client, click on yes. And here Asus gives you the option to create a DDNS entry on their domain. And it is a free option for Asus, which is very good. So if you don't have this option in your router, I have previously created a video on how to create a DDNS entry on NoIP for free. So you can check this video in the description below. So here I'm gonna leave the server on asus.com, and for host name, I'm gonna put any name here. So put a name that is significant to you. So here I'm gonna put KSTech 1971. And Asus will also give you a free certificate from Let's Encrypt. So I advise you to select the free certificate and then click on apply here. And if the registration is successful, you're gonna get this message. So here I'm gonna click on OK. And you see we have our DDNS entry created now. So now let's go to the next step, which is configuring the WireGuard VPN on our router. To set up the WireGuard VPN on your router, on the left here, scroll until you find VPN, click on VPN, and under VPN server, you have WireGuard, the last one here. So toggle this switch to on and wait for the router to apply the settings. On the right, you have the configurations of the WireGuard VPN. Keep it on general first. And the first one is access intranet. So this will permit the client to access the internet and the intranet when they connect to the WireGuard VPN. I'm gonna keep it on access intranet in case you're sharing a USB drive on your router, or if you want the client to access like devices on your home network, keep it access intranet enabled. And for the IP, you can leave it by default. This is the IP that will be distributed to the clients when they connect to the WireGuard VPN. And for the listen port, you can change it. So here it is 51,820 by default. You can put it anywhere from 1,024 to 65,535. I'm gonna leave it by default here. And then you create clients here. Before creating clients, I'm gonna go to the advanced settings so that to set it up there. So click on the drop-down list and choose advanced settings. And under advanced settings, make sure allow DNS is enabled. Enable not IPv6 is enabled also. And enable pre-shared key. This is an added layer of security. So click on it to toggle it to enable and keep everything else by default, and then click on apply all settings. So now we still have to create clients. What do clients do is when you create a client, each client has its own configuration file. So you give this configuration file to your clients, and when they connect, they will connect to the client you're creating here. I'm gonna explain the management of WireGuard at the end of this video. So make sure to watch this video until the end. So here, let's click on the plus sign to create our first client. I'm gonna create a client for my smartphone and a client for my Windows 11 PC. For the username here, put something that is significant. So I'm gonna put here phone, and then let's click on the drop-down list. So it will give the client the first IP that is available in the range of IPs for the VPN clients. So click on apply and enable. And this screen here is to share the configuration file with your clients. I'm gonna get back to this screen when I configure the client. So for now, I'm just gonna click on the X here to close it. And I'm gonna create another client here for my Windows 11 PC. And I'm gonna call it Win11. And here also click on apply. And let's close this. So now the configuration of WireGuard VPN server is finished. We still need to configure the clients so that they can access this server. I have two clients. As you see, I have my Windows 11 PC here, and also I have my Samsung Android phone. So I'm gonna show you how to configure both clients. I'm gonna start with the Windows 11 client. So here I'm gonna go back to my Asus administration page to copy the configuration file on a USB key. So here I'm gonna copy the Win11 configuration file. Click on the three dots here next to Win11. And then here, click on this icon and click on export. And then click on export here. So let's choose the USB key. So to copy the file under the USB key and click on save simply, I'm gonna keep the file name by default. So now I'm gonna take the USB key, insert it in my Windows 11 PC, and I'm gonna switch to my Windows 11 PC to show you how to make the configuration and how to connect to the VPN server. The first step we need to do on our Windows 11 PC is to download the WireGuard installation file. So open your web browser and go to wireguard.com, and here click on installation, click on the download Windows installer here. Of course, if you have another operating system, do this for your operating system. Click on open file after the file is downloaded, and then click on yes to install it. So now the file is installed. I already inserted the USB key into my Windows 11 PC, and my Windows 11 PC, by the way, is connected to an external network that has nothing to do with my home network. So I'm gonna click here on add tunnel so that to add the configuration file, and this is a configuration file selected, and then click on open. And all you have to do here is click on activate, and the connection will be activated. So now the connection is active. You have to know one thing about WireGuard is that it will tell you that the connection is active even if it couldn't make a connection. And this is something I think that should be fixed with WireGuard in later versions. So now it says that the connection is active. We're gonna test if it's active by launching on our web browser, what is my IP address? And if I get my home network IP address, it means that the connection is active and that I am browsing the internet from anywhere I am connected in the world through my home network connection. So let's open a new tab and go to what is my IP. So here I know that this is my home network IP address. So we connected to the WireGuard VPN successfully. So to prove this to you, I'm gonna disable the WireGuard client. I'm gonna keep this page active and then I'm gonna refresh it. And you're gonna see that the public IP will change. And of course the ISP will change. So let's go to the WireGuard client and I'm gonna click on deactivate and let's minimize it. And let's go here and refresh this page. And you see that all the information changed. So the connection was successful. Let me show you now how to set up the WireGuard client on your smartphone. I'm gonna switch once again to my Asus router admin page. So next to phone here, click on the three dots. And this time I'm gonna use the QR code. So this is my smartphone. The first thing you need to do on your smartphone is to install the WireGuard application. Here I have an Android phone and I already opened the Play Store. I'm gonna put in the search WireGuard and search for it and tap on install. And when the application is installed, tap on open. So tap on the plus sign on the application and then tap on scan from QR code. And tap on while using the app to allow it to scan. So now it scanned the QR code. I'm gonna name the connection home. And then tap on create tunnel. So now to activate the connection, all you have to do is to toggle the on off button to on. Before this, I'm gonna show you the IP of the phone and I'm gonna show you the IP of the phone after I connect to the tunnel. So to prove to you that you are connected, so let's go to what's my IP. And here's my IP before the VPN connection. So let's connect to the VPN now. Tap on OK. So now the VPN is connected. Let's go back to what is my IP and refresh it. And you notice that the IP changed to the IP of my home network. Now what I still want to show you is how to manage the WireGuard VPN server on your router. So I'm gonna switch once again to my Asus router. First, if you want to just stop the VPN for all the clients, all you have to do is turn the switch to off and the VPN will be stopped for for all the clients. But if you want to manage the clients one by one, for each client, you can do the following. Click on the three dots next to each client. First option is to delete the client completely, so this client will not be able to connect to your VPN anymore. And the second one is, if you click here, you can, for instance, click on the arrow here and then change the key for the client. And this way, you will oblige the client to reconfigure the VPN WireGuard client with a new configuration file. So all you have to do is click on Renew, and it will renew the keys for this client, and then click on Apply. So this way, the client cannot reconnect without re-importing the configuration file. And also, if you want to change the encryption key for everyone so that everyone will be obliged to go and renew the configuration, what you have to do is click on the drop-down list here under VPN details, and then go to Advanced Settings, and then scroll and click on Renew here. And then, of course, click on Apply All Settings. And all the clients will be forced to reconfigure their WireGuard VPN client to be able to reconnect. I hope that you liked my video and you found it useful. If you did, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it, and this will help my channel greatly. And this way, you will not miss my future videos. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. I want to thank you all for watching, and see you in the next video.